Four students at Syracuse University have been suspended for verbally assaulting an African-American student. This is just one in a series of racist incidents that have sparked student protests there. Students saying they're frustrated. They think the university is just being slow to respond.
At the same time, Syracuse police have arrested a student for spraying graffiti in support of protesting students. CNN's Polo Sandoval joins us now from Syracuse. So Polo, students, they ended a sit-in last night. What's the latest there?
Yeah, Jim, we were in the room yesterday as these students essentially came together and made that announcement that their peaceful occupation of one of the buildings on campus was coming to an end after 8 days. But in the same breath, they also called for the resignation of University Chancellor Kent Siverud, saying that they are left with no confidence in not only him, but other high-ranking administration officials. So what they're doing now, essentially ending that protest after 8 days. However, they are saying that when they come back from the Thanksgiving break, they hope that there will be at least the idea of new leadership. I did have an opportunity to speak to one of the deans on campus just before students made that announcement, and there was this consensus that many of the points that have been brought up by these students and these recommendations are in fact valid, and one university official told me there will be change.
There's hate in the world. Syracuse University is not immune to that. But I think our student demands and the solutions that they offered were not necessarily tied to this incident. This was, they actually went much deeper than that and identified areas that we can help make this place home for all of our students in a better way.
Now, we should mention that Chancellor Siverud did sign on to many of those recommendations that were made by the students. However, again, many of these students telling us that they're still not happy with the way that the administration on the campus has handled many of these latest racist incidents where racist symbols and language have been used or found on and around campus. We have reached out to the university to see if they have any reaction or response to this fresh call for the chancellor to step down. Jim and Poppy, we're still waiting to hear back from them.
Okay, Polo, thank you very much for that reporting. It's incredibly troubling to see what has taken place for some of the students there. And Syracuse is not alone. Several schools across the country right now are also investigating racist incidents. The University of Wisconsin at Eau Claire suspended five football players this week for their involvement in a racist Snapchat message. That is according to our affiliate WEAU. School officials say there was an image of a burning cross and a message referencing an African-American student group.
Goodness, in the year 2019, at the University of Georgia this week, swastikas found on a message boards at two residence halls, plus Iowa State University police investigating a swastika etched into a door in a resident hall there. School officials also report racist stickers and posters being left on light poles and bus stops around campus. Imagine how alarming that is for people of color there.